Matchroom CEO and promoter Eddie Hearn is ecstatic that his fighter, unified British heavyweight champion Anthony Joshua and undefeated WBC American heavyweight champion Deontay Wilder fluctuate on being who's the favorite. 1 week, Wilder's the favorite. Next week, Joshua's the favorite. And that just makes Eddie Hearn ecstatic. Stay tuned, coming up next.
Hey, this is Cassie, and you're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV.
You're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV.
You're watching Blue Blood Sports TV. Hola, habla Cindy. Está viendo Deportes TV.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So Eddie Hearn, Matchroom CEO and promoter, the promoter of unified British heavyweight champion Anthony Joshua, and said in a recent interview that he is absolutely ecstatic on the fact that Anthony Joshua is the favorite this week, and then the next week, Deontay Wilder is the favorite. He stated that, you know, it just makes him excited. They know that Anthony Joshua, this is what Eddie Hearn stated, they know that Anthony Joshua, it's a big risk, and Anthony Joshua could lose his belt. He said that one day Anthony Joshua could be the champion, and he steps in the ring with Deontay Wilder, and next thing you know, he's not the champion. They know it's a huge risk, but the same goes vice versa. Deontay Wilder could step through the ropes with the WBC belt and then lose to Anthony Joshua. That's what makes it exciting. He said that when you hear people like George Foreman say this is the biggest heavyweight fight in the history of boxing, he said that, you know, that just makes him exciting. That just makes me ecstatic, is what Eddie Hearn said. He says to be a part of that is just wonderful. You know, it's a wonderful feeling to take part in it, you know, for himself, for his fighter to take part in it. He stated that, you know, it's really, you know, it gets your adrenaline pumping, you know, it's an adrenaline rush because you know that Anthony Joshua could lose, is what Eddie Hearn said. He said, but on the other side, you know that Deontay Wilder could lose, so anybody could lose. So he says that, you know, it just makes him absolutely ecstatic. It makes him excited. It gets Anthony Joshua excited. It gets the adrenaline pumping. It's a rush, you know. You know, the sacrifice, the risk that you're taking. And I have to agree with Eddie Hearn. This was reminiscent of Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao. When Floyd Mayweather would fight, everybody would say Floyd Mayweather is going to beat Manny Pacquiao. And then Manny Pacquiao fight a week or two later, and then everybody say Manny Pacquiao is going to beat Floyd Mayweather. Because it's a case of out of sight, out of mind. And, you know, it's a case of being caught up in the moment, a prisoner of the moment, so to speak. And so now everybody has said that since Deontay Wilder this past weekend knocked out Dominic Brazil in dramatic fashion, 2 minutes and 17 seconds into the first round. Anthony Joshua knocked out Dominic Brazil, took him 7 rounds to do it. So it just heightened the interest for this fight. And so now most people, I'm seeing a lot of people saying that Deontay Wilder is going to beat Anthony Joshua via knockout. Now Anthony Joshua fights next Saturday. And depending upon how he looks in that fight and how this fight turns out, people may turn around and say, you know what, after watching Anthony Joshua is going to win this fight. And I have to agree with Eddie Hearn. It is exciting to see the buildup. You know, for most people, the most exciting part of life is the chase. You know, it's the buildup towards everything. You know, it's the chase of getting the money, right? Becoming a millionaire. When you're a millionaire, you want to be a two-time millionaire, multi-millionaire, right? You want to be a billionaire. It's the chase, right? A lot of people just don't live in the moment. And so with that, you know, it's the buildup to this fight is what's interesting. Everybody's curious to see what happens when these two giants of heavyweight, Deontay Wilder, 6'7", 225 pounds, Anthony Joshua, 6'6", 250 pounds. Are they giants as heavyweights, right? And it's very interesting to see. You know, Anthony Joshua has a high knockout percentage. Deontay Wilder has a high knockout percentage. Deontay Wilder's knocked down or knocked out every opponent he stepped in the ring with. Anthony Joshua has knocked out every opponent he stepped in the ring with outside of, with the exception of Joseph Parker. But with that said, you know, it's very, very exciting to see, you know, the sport of boxing have these types of buildups. We also have Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford. You know, there's a lot of fights on the horizon. There's a lot of buildup, and I'm happy for the sport of boxing, just being a fan of the sport of boxing. Now, we definitely want to get these fights as soon as possible because we are like instant gratification, me, myself included. I want to see the fight like yesterday, Anthony Joshua versus Deontay Wilder. And if I couldn't see it yesterday, I want to see it today or tomorrow. That's just how we are as fans of the sport of boxing. So I agree with Eddie Hearn when he states that, you know, it's exciting, it gets him ecstatic. You know, 1 week, Deontay Wilder's the favorite. Next week, Anthony Joshua's the favorite. And he's spot on with that. Like I said, it puts me in the mindset of Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao. I remember when Manny Pacquiao beat Miguel Cotto, everybody said, oh, he's going to beat Floyd Mayweather. I remember when Floyd Mayweather beat Miguel Cotto. Oh, he beat him differently, so he's going to beat Pacquiao. I remember when Floyd Mayweather beat Shane Mosley. I remember Emmanuel Stewart saying he picks every fight from fight to fight. Emmanuel Stewart reiterated this. He stated, you know, I watched this fight with Floyd Mayweather and Shane Mosley, and it's hard for me to pick against Floyd Mayweather. I think Floyd Mayweather is going to beat Manny Pacquiao. And then he watched Manny Pacquiao 2 weeks later, and he's like, you know something? I think Manny Pacquiao is going to beat Floyd Mayweather. And that's similar, you know, situation we're getting with Deontay Wilder and Anthony Joshua. My only gripe is I hope that we get it before. I think that fight happened far too late. It happened 4 years too late. It should have happened 4 years earlier. So with that said, I think if that fight had passed its prime, and with that, you know, it forced, you know, we saw a lackluster fight. Floyd Mayweather was Floyd Mayweather as he usually is, but Manny Pacquiao just didn't have it. He had ended up getting knocked out by Juan Manuel Marquez, a brutal knockout Manny Pacquiao suffered to Juan Manuel Marquez, and the fight just never had the same feeling to it. With that said, you know, hopefully these fighters could get it on. They're both taking risks. You know, Anthony Joshua was going to take on the likes of Jarrell Big Baby Miller. That's a high-risk fight for him. I know a lot of people don't see it that way, but it truly is, especially in the heavyweight division. Anything could happen. Deontay Wilder took on Dominic Brazil. Now it's seeming like he's going to take on Luis King Kong Ortiz. That's another dangerous fight. And if Anthony Joshua faced the likes of Dillian White, that's a personal fight, right? So that fight is dangerous, you know. So, you know, hopefully these fighters come together and we get the super fight, the super heavyweight fight. As George Foreman put it, he feels like this is the biggest fight in heavyweight division boxing history. You know, so it is a very huge fight. There's a lot on the line with this fight, and I can't wait to see how it plays out. Well, that's all I got for y'all, man. Eddie Hearn said it just makes him absolutely ecstatic gets his blood rushing, his blood flowing. It gets him, you know, it's a rush, you know, it's an adrenaline rush. You know, 1 week, you know, Josh was the favorite. Next week, Wilder's the favorite. You know, and so it's a rush, you know, because it's a high risk. You know what I mean? Everybody knows that they have something huge at stake, and everybody knows that the other one could lose. So it's very, very interesting. So I agree with Eddie Hearn on this point. But that's all I got for y'all, man. It's your boy Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
The Blue Blood Sports TV, baby, from the